good day to audience around the world. Today is Monday, November 16th, 2020, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfang. Welcome to the weekly report of the World New Religion, Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao at Weixin TV Station. Let's begin with the latest update of Weixin Shenjiao Amitabha Buddha birthday celebration and benediction ritual for national protection and disaster elimination. In response to the global pandemic of COVID-19, Weixin fellows follow the holy revelation of Wang Chan Lao Zu and the religious rites instructed by Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi to offer this 99-day Dharma feast and to continuously pray for the pandemic and natural disasters subside in 196 countries around the world. During the ritual, the students of Yijing University spontaneously registered for the task of stir-frying the five grains. The participants traveled from various places in Taiwan to our headquarters, Xianfu's Temple, in the middle of the night. Following the procedures and timetable of Weixin World Peace Promotion Association, everyone worked together to complete the important Dharma task of stir-frying the grains and spreading the grain ashes at Weixin Shenjiao main altar. Performing this rite is for the long-term stability of the world and for the world to be able to harvest grains without war. Let's watch the following detailed report and listen to the latest instruction from Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi on the current status of the global epidemic.
Headquarters, Chengdishan Xianfu Temple of Chengdishan Weixin Shenjiao held ritual for Amitabha Buddha birthday celebration for national protection and disaster elimination of the year Dongzi. The ritual lasted 99 days long and finished completed on night. This is the 60th ritual we have ever had. On every morning, we had Dean of Weixin Shenjiao Chanting College and Master Yuan Song led Weixin Virtuous Fellows and representatives chanting scriptures to worship the spirits from the three realms and the 10 Dharma directions along with incense, flowers, fruits, and delicacy. In addition, we had volunteers prepared 5 crops, flowers, incense, and wine to worship the plague shrouded over 196 countries. With benefits from chanted scriptures, we prayed for disasters elimination, grievances resolving, prosperity and harvest, and no hunger for human beings. While people around the world pay attention to the U.S. president election, COVID-19 continued to ravage the world and is now breaking the 50 million confirmed cases. In the United States, it's now fatal stage with confirmed cases increased over 100,000 cases every day. In Europe, the epidemic is even more severe with 1 million new confirmed cases every 3 days. According to foreign media reports, Europe has become the most severely affected area in the world, accounting for 51% of new cases and 24% of death worldwide. Among them, France had an average of 54,400 new cases every day in the past week, which is more severe than India. European countries is now under a new status of lockdown. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi gave Weixin Virtuous Fellows some encouraging words on night. The karma of human beings accumulate profoundly, and it is really hard to resolve it at one time. We hope all Weixin Virtuous Fellows would continue to work on scripture chanting to eliminate disasters and resolve grievances.
九九法会已经过到第60坛了，每一坛都是本着天心造大地，天心造人间，明阳两界同关照。 的原则，大家很用心、很努力的，在为国修道、为人类来祈福，这是维新圣教的教义落实在每一个阶段、每一个的天运。 有灾劫，有祸患来的时候，所有维新弟子、佛会大众等 君以诚心虔心来恭送诸君和供养三宝，供养香花果串以及供养五谷，化为珍宝来供养法会坛上各个连坐诸祖灵、诸圣灵皆得与我唯心贤士同修合会，心香法界照太平，共祈天下太平的大法轮。庚子年的天温来来往往，去而复来，来而又去，在这里反反复复的，因为众生的业太深厚，累积了无量劫来的深厚的怨恨情仇，所以在当下性一下子要全部灭掉是一个很困难的，但是我们不会因而退道，我们所有唯心贤士本着为国修道、为人类祈福的终极目标，我们再努力、再努力、再努力，以达台湾的平安。在当下，今日第六十坛，整个的地球北端的疫情将在那反反复复，所以我们了解了，我们就仍然以经宝来供养，来作为解冤释结、消灾化解。所以我们今天已经是六十坛了，我们感恩玉皇大帝允我为先弟子和为大众的表达和修行方志，祈愿呢龙天护法保苍生，化解明阳两界的战争，一愿人心相疼爱，同祈世界永和平这个是人类的尊严和人类要努力的方向。我们祈愿各位唯心弟子、佛会大众等，你们都很辛苦你们的辛苦是会得到报偿和代价的回馈，给各位你们的努力、你们的心血所以希望各位同学们大家再接再厉务必达到老祖师尊给我们的方向，天下太平，天下太平，台湾平安，世界真和平祝福各位。
微星 report 南投。
Take a break, we will come back soon. The 15th altar of Chinese United Ancestors Worship Ceremony of Changjishan Weixin Shenjiao will be held at 1 p.m. on January 1st, 2021 at Taoyuan Linkou Stadium in Taiwan. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that this would be the completion altar for the ancestor worship ceremony. All the branch temples and the fellow cultivators are making full preparation for the upcoming grand ceremony. The solemn Dharma feast, fragrant flowers, fruit and delicacy dishes, spiritual treasures, and the Dharma treasures from each educational and research unit of Weixin Shenjiao will be presented in the ceremony as the offerings not only to Buddhas and deities, but also to the common ancestors of mankind. We will then sincerely pray for world peace by gathering the hearts of filial piety through tracing back the origin in the ceremony. Please enter the special report of the ancestor worship ceremony.
The 15th order of the Chinese United Ancestors Worship Ceremony is going to be hosted on January 1st, 2021 at Linkou Arena. Weixin Shenjiao has started to host Ancestors Worship Ceremony since 2004 for worshiping Chinese ancestors, tracing the starting point of all human grievances back to the grievance of the battle of three Chinese ancestors in Zhuolu to resolve grievances of specific historical character. This ancestors worship ceremony is not only to settle ancestors' might, bring harmony to generations of the Chinese hand in hand, heart to heart, but also together to turn the Dharma wheel of world peace, pray for the world as one family. During the cultivation assembly with the staff of the temple on November 9th, Weixin Shenjiao Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi reminds Director Mr. Wu of Chinese United Ancestors Worship Ceremony Association and Master Yuan Yi that all Weixin Virtuous Fellows should fully devolve themselves into the preparation works of the 15th Order of Ancestors Worship Ceremony. This altar will be the completion altar, the lotus seeds of the gods of plague and negativities in 196 countries are going to be invited to Linkou Arena to receive the veneration and Dharma offerings, pray for return back to the Southern Heaven Pure Land and reborn in the Western Buddhist Pure Land. Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi requests that each branch temple and each unit of Weixin Shenjiao should work closely with best attitude to contribute the success of the ceremony. Meanwhile, he also encouraged virtuous fellows continue its efforts to invite personal affiliates join this wonderful ceremony and together see our ancestors off return back to the Western Buddhist Pure Land. Ancestors Worship Ceremony Association and each branch temple all followed Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi's instructions, presided the preparatory meeting to make the arrangements of gathering people and public transport to attend the 15th completion order of 2021 Chinese United Ancestors Worship Ceremony, Weixin Report Headquarters Sanfusi Temple.
For celebrating and welcoming the 2021st Chinese Xinchou Year of Ox, Ding Yuancang of the Planning Institute of Weixin Shenjiao is planning a garden landscape theme of Welcome the Year of Gold Ox with Spring Flowers. Last week, Ding Yuancang reported the theme to Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi at Weixin Shenjiao Bagua Holy City. Let's learn more about it.
The code of feng shui is blended into the nature of the constructions that Weixin Shenjiao has planned with an emphasis on this point. Because of careful planning, people who visit Weixin Shenjiao will enjoy the beauty of the nature. Weixin Shenjiao Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi had a tour of inspection on the 6th. At Baguang Mountain, Yijing University, where Weixin Shenjiao main order is located, he had a discussion with Ding Yuancang of the Planning Institute regarding the garden landscape in Yijing University. The new year is around the corner, and Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi is planning to decorate the Yijing University garden themed Welcome the Year of Gold Ox with spring flowers to encourage people visiting Yijing University. Since the world has been suffered from the pandemic a lot, Grandmaster Hunyuan Chanshi hopes that people can welcome the future with hope and happiness. At the same time, a trail to the garden has been reserved to let the visitors take pictures and to avoid flowers from stepping. Later on, Grandmaster Wen Yuanchan Shi walked to the part of garden near the Nine Dragons Wall. Compared to Garden Blow, this area is not only quiet, but also beautiful. In addition, an arbor sitting at the corner of the garden has a full view of Nantou City, which will amaze people. Wei Xinsheng Jiao Yijing University welcomes everyone to visit. It's a place that you can definitely relax yourself so as to have courage to embrace the future. Wei Xin report, Wei Xinsheng Jiao Main Order.
For another branch temple activities, the temple host of Tainan Guiren Da Shi Dian Hou, Dr. Yang Wucai, offered the course of Tianlong 8 style Qigong at the starting point of World Peace Taichung Branch Temple on November 7th. Please watch the footage of the first course.
Being the director of Chinese Qigong Therapy Association, Abbot of Taiwan San Da Shi Dian Temple and daughter of Chinese medicine, Dr. Yang Wucai, Open Tai Chi Heavenly Dragon 8 Style Qigong class at Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Branch Temple on 7th of November. He delivered the skill of combining body, heart, and spirit in practicing to explore invisible potential and character, as well as creating new energy. The class started on Saturdays from 7 to 9 p.m. Each session lasts for 2 months. All Virtuous Fellows are welcome to join and learn to complete their body and soul. Dr. Yang attended the interview of TV program, The Immortal Trace of Wang Chan Nao Zhu, introducing Heavenly Dragon 8 Styles Qi Gong, which received Outstanding Qi Gong Prize for 5 consecutive years in International Medical Qi Gong Demonstration Ceremony between 2006 and 2019. This award was published in the International Medical Qigong Magazine. This Qigong is easy to manage, which is suitable to modern people to train physically and mediate their bodies and organs. Their health can have remarkable improvement with only 10 minutes practice per day. Dr. Yang led the fellows to practice Zen meditation at Yangxian Hall and demonstrated Heavenly Dragon 8 styles at Ultimate Plaza. He shared the breathing skill and the action pattern. All Virtuous Fellows had opportunity to learn. Weixin Report, Taichung.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
自即日起，维新电视在中华电信 MOD 已。
It's time for Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Feature Story. My colleague is here to share with you the real story of how to utilize Yi Jing Feng Shui in our daily lives. We should enjoy the story of this week.
Hello, everyone. Ami Tuo Fo. Welcome back to Wei Xin Sheng Jiao Feature Story. Today, we are going to continue the real story about Mr. Liu. Last month, there was one virtuous fellow, Mr. Liu, returned to Xianfu Si Temple to express gratitude to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, since all of his family members were high-tempered. It would frequently bring his whole family into conflict with each other when they get together. Around 1 year ago, Mr. Liu started to watch Wei Xin TV station. He found that it is really helpful when his whole family see the program Wei Xin World Affairs, recorded by Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi every night. His family was surprisingly less of acrimony. He further told to Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi that he felt happy and calm in his mind after seeing the program. However, he found that he was easy to get upset if he was too busy to watch the program. Hui Yuan Chan Shi told Mr. Liu that it was wrong if he found that his mind was in turmoil without seeing the program. Each time when someone gave us a few words of wisdom, we should practice it in our daily life. Otherwise, it will become useless, like we just glancing idly through a magazine. According to Geng Hua from Yi Jing, Geng means mountain. When we overturned the balls, its shape was like a mountain. Such constant characteristic and sympathy represent our natural of minds. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi suggested Mr. Liu to place some balls and overturn it in every corner of his home. When conflicts arise in his family, those overturned balls will remind them to be like a steel mountain, because mountains would always exist here, no matter it is raining, windy, or suffering from sunburn. Only when they realize it, his family members can deal with temper and improve it. After another 2 weeks, he came back to Xianfosi Temple again and pressed the bowl truly had the Lord. He followed what he was advised from Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, and it has been 10 days since he overturned some bowls in the corners of his home and found that his family could get along well without argument. Hun Yuan Chan Shi told him, "There is none lord of the bowl. It is our natural, constant self-natural. When we see overturned bowls, it reminds us to reach the calmness of mind. We don't need to pursue Tao in high mountains, because Chan is everywhere in the mundane world, and Tao exists everywhere around us in our daily lives." Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi further instructed, "The trigram of Geng is a yang yao on top of two yin yao. It means that we can cover up all our worries in the overturned balls just as Geng Gua Xiong. However, if we place the bowl upright, it becomes Zheng Gua, which is a yang yao at the bottom of two yin yao. That is just like all the darkness of worries blocks the brightness. The only way to leave worries is to have the determination. That is the Chan." Thank you for watching today's feature story. We wish you all the best, peace, and health. See you next time.
In terms of our branch temple activities, Kaohsiung Shanlin Branch Temple has been successful in planting pumpkins for many years and has accumulated a lot of farming experiences. Pumpkin seedlings began to be planted on November 3rd. Let's participate in the busy farming process of Master Yuan Pu and the fellow cultivators.
On November 3rd, the virtuous fellow Huang Yulong, under the instruction of Master Yuan Pu, the abbot of Changjishan Wei Xingshen Jiao Kaohsiung Shanlin Branch Temple, to lead the volunteers to plant chestnut pumpkin seedlings, hoping for the good harvest. Shanlin Branch Temple started planting high unit price chestnut pumpkin in 2017. This year has entered its fourth year. Due to a lack of technical guidance at the beginning, all volunteers learned from experience, so the first year's harvest was not satisfactory. After 3 years of experimentation and learning, last year's planting of 3,000 square meters of land yielded a harvest of more than 1,800 kilograms. After deducting the cost of fertilizer and materials, it also brought another extra income to the branch temple. This year, Virtuous Fellow Huang Yulong was instructed by Master Yuan Pu to purchase 1,200 chestnut pumpkin seeds to start growing seedlings, which can already be transplanted to the farmland. At 8 a.m. on November 3rd, the Virtuous Fellows who participated in the planting organized the farmland under the leadership of Virtuous Fellow Huang. A day before, Virtuous Fellow Huang and Virtuous Fellow Hong of Shanlin Branch Temple had returned the soil and sprinkled the soil with fertilizer, and sorted out the outline, tidied up a bit, and sprayed the weed-proof plastic cloth, and let it prepare to be planted. Master Yuan Pu also brought offerings and led the virtuous fellows to burn incense to the local mountain gods and lord of the land. praying for the good harvest of chestnut pumpkins every year. Immediately began to organize the farmland. Chestnut pumpkins are afraid of heat damage. When the weather is hot, there are many diseases and insect pests. The branch temple uses organic planting. Therefore, it is necessary to carefully manage the farmland and take care of the planting. In the afternoon, the virtuous fellows began to transplant pumpkins, started pumping water for irrigation. It is hoped that 3 months later, there will be another year of a great harvest of chestnut pumpkins. Weixin Report, Shanling Branch Temple.
Taiwan has enjoyed a relatively stable condition in the midst of COVID-19. Yet, we would like to invite every global citizen to put the prevention measures into practice. Wear face masks, wash your hands, no touching of the eyes, mouth, and noses. Maintain social distancing. Together, we should fight against the pandemic and maintain the proper functions of our societies. Thank you for tuning in today. We will be back with more updates about Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 a.m. and 4 o'clock p.m. of the local time in Taiwan on every Tuesday on Weixin TV. May the pandemic end soon and everyone can enjoy a peaceful and harmonious life. See you next week.